Anglican Girls Grammar School, AGGS Benin City, was a cynosure of all eyes and a citadel of learning for girls founded in the year 1961. The school in the 60s and early 80s was an educational Eldorado for the girl child. But from the late 90s till now, the once-famed school with top-of-the-notch facilities for learning has become a shadow of its old self. The classrooms are dilapidated, hostels overgrown with weeds, and all kinds of squatters have taken over the designated hostels and classrooms and has turned same to their private residential buildings. Classrooms in the school has been converted to staff room to accommodate staffs. The school has no fence. Thus, so many footpaths had been circuited as a result, and this negates security for pupils and staff. There exists a caricature basketball court that is now used for social parties and other businesses that has no relevance to the school extracurricular activities. Although government did make an effort to renovate some of the classrooms and 3 science laboratory, but their effort created more harm than good. As we speak, none of the laboratories is functional. As a matter of urgency, the school had to be properly fenced around with a gate and a security house to keep out squatters and miscreants. Sack the squatters, renovate the hostels and dining hall so boarding house system can be reintroduced. Recreational facilities must be reintroduced for the mental and physical well-being of the children. The science laboratory must be renovated and equipped to a modern state as it exists everywhere else. The American chapter of AGGS Old Girls Association has done great by providing sanitary facility in the school compound, but they can still do more as AGGS is their alma mater. If these renovations are made, AGGS would get back to our old glory.
Mrs. Hato Messi, Principal Anglican Girls Grammar School, Senior School. So many things are lacking for now. What would have been our priority? If we have a choice, is the fencing of the school. You can see that the school is very close. You can access it from all directions. And this is not too good enough for an institution such as this. Then we talk of the laboratory. The government has renovated. This is the extent they have come so far. But if you look at what we are seeing here, the benches, the tables for the chemistry lab are detailed. Then the fixing of the pipes. We need the pipes to be fixed. We need the washing basin. Then of course, we need the equipment to build the lab. What makes a standard laboratory so that others can come here too? Want to copy what AGGS has done. For now, nothing happened. Those were here before the contract was awarded by the state government. The project is ongoing, so that is why the doors have not been fixed. But I believe that if the new government has taken over, maybe they come back, the doors will be fixed and probably the times will be taken again. But in that project, equipment of the lab is out of it.
Yes, I'm Mrs. Sajori, the vice principal of the seniors and the candidates from the school. Of course, we want a conducive learning environment for the student, not just my child. Conducive environment. Like the principal, but rest, the fencing of the school is very, very vital. No matter what you put on ground, if the fence is not in place, then we are not sure of, you know, 100% keeping whatever government or any other person that provided. Fence is very, very vital. We had a case recently where people came in and removed the fans that they contracted in the other building.
Wow.
They removed some of the fans. And you see, we are helpless.
And even the soil.
We are helpless. We need a fence. We need a fence. Very important. After that, of course, the lab. Yeah, science is the thing these days. Very, very important for any school. So the lab, as you can see, is very important. It's there now. The contractors are supposed to be working on it, but there's a change of government. And we are hoping that they will come back to put the structure right.
Do you have enough furnitures for class, all the classrooms? Are they properly furnished?
Well, not quite. We want more.
We'll see. What is your sporting activities like here? Do you have the equipment, you have the facilities for...
Nothing on ground. The only thing visible that you can see is the tennis court. And look at it, it's even bare. Nothing on ground for sports activities.
AGGS is a famous school. They used to have body camps. Do you still have that?
No.
What happened? Are there no structures for body
camps? There were structures, but it's gone now. The structures are over there, as you can see. But it's gone. Has gone with very big tree in the middle of the building, big tree. So you can imagine how long ago the school started.
Mr. Itoya Joel Ebodage of BP Academics of the school. On a learning environment, we will expect something better than this. I know the government at the point to try to provide some of the structure you have seen. We have seen these chairs. The chairs are really of poor quality. Now the structures are undergoing renovations. You can see the red roof. But it's not going the way we expected. You've just come here and met the laboratory without us. We expected that all this would have been fixed by now. But the story, mobilization, non-mobilization actually has punctuated the jobs. And then the principal talked about the fence. As for me, I would say the fence alone is not enough. This is a girls' school. Ought to be secured, properly secured. That we won't need a security. If you have the fence and there is no security, there will still be intrusion of hoodlums. This will even be a better hideout if we fence it and nobody is there to checkmate the activities in the hood. So we will need a security as well as the fence. But fence alone would not actually solve all the problems of porosity.
So in your, what do you need now most?
Yeah.
What do you need now for your school?
Like we need a fence, and I say we need a security man. Okay. Then the science laboratory was an ideal school at this time. I think we preach science these days. A school without laboratory, know that science cannot be properly taught. So we need the laboratory to be equipped, and then we need more teachers. That is government. And again, you were asking for hostels. Well, I think if anything can be done in the hostel, that we have occupants in the, squatters. Okay, something can be done about it too. Let this place be free, be exclusively for learning. It's a learning environment for girls. So it is not really too ideal having
external sense and
within the system. So what we expect here would be the teachers. You are in the body now.
You have teachers' quarters here.
We have teachers' quarters. They are not maintained. They are dilapidated.
And not functional at all.
Squatters have taken over the place.
Squatters?
Yeah.
Oh, you have foreign bodies living in your compound?
Yeah, that's what I just said.
A lot of them.
A lot of them. It's almost...
Are you 60 family?
Yeah.
This is almost...
Who are not your staff? Who are not...
They moved in. Just move in the host they have been. They just come use with the market and...
Tell you,
they have permission to live there.
My name is Justice Aigbe. I'm a chemistry teacher in this college. Well, it's been for a very short time. I was just posted there. I was posted there about 2-3 months ago. I actually came in from Edo College. So when I came in here, the last time I came to this college was some 20 years ago, but what I saw was not too impressive. Because I know what has only gone wrong with the school system. But so far, so good, I've been made to understand that stakeholders have been coming around to improve on the facilities, and we are very, very hopeful that things will go for better. Yes, you see, education is something that everybody desires to have. And for you to have a good education, you need materials and infrastructure that will enable the students to learn and the teachers to teach. So these are some of the things that is highly desirable. And we are pleading with all stakeholders, government, the old guests of the college, even the management of the college, to improve on these facilities in whatever way they can, because they go a long way helping in teaching and learning.
Neat.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, in the science department, you know very well, science is a practical subject. It's a very practical subject. And in the area of chemistry, physics, and biology, we need the laboratories. And laboratories, well-equipped laboratories, that will facilitate teaching and learning.
Thank you very much.
From the background of Edo College, it will interest you to know I'm also the secretary, the Benin branch secretary of Edo College Youth Boys Association. I attended Edo College. And you know what the Youth Boys have been doing over there. So we also plead, not just with the government, because government cannot do everything, especially the major stakeholders, which are the old guests of this college. Government will go, government will come, parents will come, they will go. But the ones that will stay eternally are the old guests. They own the school. So they can be a very strong stakeholder in the college projects. So we are begging, we are employing them to see what they can do to give this school a desirable facelift. Thank you.
My name is Anthony Sandra. I'm the recent health girl of Anglican Girls Grammar School. I am a student of SS3A science class. Actually, we lack some basic equipment in our school. Like the physics lab, we don't have enough equipment to carry out our experiments, and our WAEC is coming up, so we don't have enough facility. We lack facilities. And our school, there's lack of security. Our school is not fenced. During closing time, you see people tripping into the school, and some of them, they are causing very disastrous things. Even our classrooms, our windows, some of them, they just break it. I don't know. We need security. We need the school to be fenced. We are asking you to please come to our aid and help our school, fence our school. We need good security in our school. When he came, he promised to give us good classroom. Well, actually, he did, but he did not fulfill all he promises. He just left. If you see, you go behind the school, you see a building that they removed the roof, but they didn't finish it. They didn't complete the project. So it was not really effective. I will ask if, please, they can just come to our aid and they can just help us, because we need security. They're like, we normally hold lecture in our school, but even when our lecture is still going on, we still see that all these boys, they are still coming to the school. They are causing dangerous things. They are causing disastrous things in our school, so we don't like it. We need your help urgently.
My name is Esther Ricky, a student of Akangas Grammar School, SS3 student, ex-timekeeper. Well, I would really say that it's kind of really, really bad, because our schools, our classrooms are being destroyed by intruders. Like, our facilities are bad. Just so devastating. Well, first thing I would think fencing. In the case of security, intruders coming to the school, maybe when we're having lessons, we are being distracted by some people passing through our classes, and sometimes from vehicle just intruding, start playing loud songs, and we're unable to focus. And our properties, like our physics lab, the properties there are being destroyed by intruders, like our biology laptops, so our equipment are just so, you know, scattered and not all around them. Stuff like that. A lot, I would say. Like, our classes are not made for like a drinking kind of bar. They drink in our classes. Our roofs are being removed sometimes. Our windows are broken. Our doors are being removed. Sometimes even the ceiling fan, which was placed by the governor, was removed. And sometimes our chemistry lab, some of our pupils, all those beakers are being broken. They're just using it for fun. And though we need it, but they are using it for fun. Well, I want them to please just be the friends for us around the school, because I think that friends is the best thing we need right now, like security, because our school is not safe at all. Well, recently, due to the fact that we are girls, our principal were able to bring security, like this policeman, so that they can guide around. But though they're not fully guiding the school, because it's a kind of a big school and not all sites and all points can be guided. So, but they're making kind of possible effort to help us. Well, my expectation is for them to, you know, build a fence for us. Like, we really need that. We need security and we need some kind of facilities in our labs.